In this video, we'll learn how to recolor artwork in Illustrator. To practice recoloring, I've got the file editcolorgroupdemo.ai open from this week's demo files. Here, I've got a design for my emoji, and I've assigned it some colors using a color group that I generated with the color guide panel. I can see that group here in my swatches panel, along with a couple of other groups here for different shades and tints of that same tetrad color group. I'd like to see what my artwork looks like with colors from those other color groups instead of the palette I currently have. So let's go ahead and select all the artwork we'd like to recolor. So I'll just click and drag with my selection tool and select everything. Then we'll bring up the Recolor Artwork dialog by clicking Edit, Edit Colors, Recolor Artwork from the menu bar. First, we'll see this simplified version. So let's go down to the bottom and click Advanced Options. Here we'll see an interface that's almost identical to the Edit Colors dialog. So we've got our color group here at the top, next to our base color. Then to the right, our harmony rules and our color group column that mirrors what we have in the swatches panel. The main difference here is that we've got this new Assign tab next to our Edit tab. And this lets us really quickly and easily shift the colors in our existing palette and replace them with a new set. So I'll make sure down in the lower left that my Recolor Art checkbox is checked, and that way I'll be able to see the updates that I'm making. So let's go ahead and assign some colors from a different color group. And we can do that just by clicking on it in the color groups column. Notice that Illustrator has now replaced the colors of my artwork with the colors from that selected color group. Now, if I didn't like what I had here in the color groups column, I could also click on the harmony rules dropdown and just create a whole new group on the fly. Let's take a closer look at the Assign tab and see exactly how our colors are being changed. So each row in the Assign tab takes one or more current colors in our artwork and replaces it with a new color. The arrow icon in a row lets us know that the current color or colors are actively being mapped to the new color. If we'd like to keep that current color the same, we can just click the arrow icon. Notice that it changes to a dash, and in my artwork, that color stays the same, so it doesn't get changed to a new color. If I decide that I do want to change it, I can click the dash icon. Notice it changes back to an arrow, and now that color is included in the color change. Illustrator doesn't always do the best job guessing at which new colors should replace which current colors. So luckily, we can really easily swap our new colors just by clicking and dragging in the New Colors column. And as I do that, I can see the changes I'm making updated in my artwork. Right now, I have the advantage of starting out with a pretty simple color palette. I only have four colors in my original artwork, and I'm mapping onto four colors in my new color group. Sometimes, though, I'll have more colors, or for whatever reason, I want to consolidate current colors together and replace them with the same color. For example, maybe I'd like to replace both the black and the red with one new color. In that case, I can click and drag any of the current colors and drop them onto their neighbors to consolidate them together. So now I can see that both black and red in my current colors are being replaced by this one new color. Now by default, our new color is going to replace the darkest current color. So in that case, black gets replaced by the exact new color from my color group. The other colors in that consolidated row are then replaced with proportionally lighter tints of the new color. So I can see what started as my red interior becomes a lighter tint of that new color. If we'd like that color consolidation to happen in a different way, we can click the dropdown next to the new color for that row. Here I could change to several different options. For example, maybe I'd like to choose exact, which will replace each current color exactly with the new color. So when I click this option, I can see that both the black and the red are replaced exactly with my new color. Now, if I change my mind and decide that I don't want to consolidate these colors, I can right-click and select Separate Colors into Different Rows. As I'm working, I might get to a point where I decide that I don't like how the new color palette is looking. In that case, I can reset to my original artwork colors just by clicking the Reset button in the upper right of the Recolor Artwork dialog. And now I'm back to my original color palette. So maybe instead I'd like to try switching to this other color group. And again, just click and drag in the New Colors column to change the order of my replacements. Other times, I may not want to completely reset to the original color palette, but I do want to see where in my artwork one of the current original colors is located. In that case, I can click on this Click on Colors Above to Find Them in Artwork button, just below the color bars in the Assign tab. Then, when I click on a color in the Current Colors column, the artwork with that color will appear in full color on my artboard, and the rest will be dimmed. So this lets me figure out where a current color is located in my artwork. And that's especially helpful when you start to have very complex shapes or a very complex color palette for your file. And we can just click that icon again to return to the artwork in full color. Now, I'm finding that this new color group is much too dark for what I want, so let's switch to a different group. Then I'll click OK to finalize my color assignments. Okay, that's how to recolor artwork in Illustrator.